So let me read one of these tips. This is communication tip number 51. When a feeling isn't a feeling. Many times we express our feelings and emotions as evaluations or judgments, like, I feel that you, dot, 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 or you make me feel, dot, dot, dot. That's the one that's going to get you in trouble. Or I feel as if you, now we're really going to get in trouble because we're going to put the blame and shame on another person. So let me go on with this. When we express in this way, we are not expressing our emotions, but how we are thinking. Plus, it can get us into trouble by being seen as blaming and shaming the person we're talking to. Instead, okay, express a feeling or ask another about their emotions, like, I feel frustration, or I'm tired, I'm feeling tired. Expressing emotions in this way helps us to be clear with our emotions and feelings and keeps us out of our thoughts, our judgments, our evaluations. So we want to stay away from, I feel like, I feel as if, because these are, again, judgments and evaluations. We want to use a real feeling. And again, you can go to walkyourtalk.org and download a feelings list and the needs list. So we want to express our feelings as, I feel tired, I feel exhausted, I feel happy, I'm ecstatic, I'm in beautiful Santa Barbara right now. So this is how we express feelings. And anytime you start expressing your emotions, your feelings, with I feel that you, or I feel that I, we're going to maybe get in trouble that way because we're not expressing emotions or feelings. We're going to be expressing an evaluation or a judgment. So this is Rick Goodfriend with my book, I Hear You, But, with over 100 of these communication tips. And please go to the website, walkyourtalk.org, and you'll be able to look at it more off of amazon.com or order it if you want to. May all your needs be met all week long.